Cab over ZIL 132 are with three axles, the leading all-terrain vehicle of its time. ZIL 132 R is an experienced multi-purpose 5-ton cab over truck tractor, built in early May 1974, an improved modification of the ZIL 132 variant. Like many Soviet developments of those times, it carried a whole string of innovative solutions. And during off-road tests, he made not only any car, but also tracked vehicles. However, fate decreed that this truck never served its intended purpose. In the early 70s, the agro-industrial complex of the USSR was faced with the growing need for special automotive equipment. The widespread then 130th Zili did not at all meet the necessary requirements for carrying capacity, cross-country ability, and the ability to transform for any economic purpose. Tractors and tracked vehicles, due to their low speed, also could not provide high productivity. Therefore, ZIL and a number of other Soviet car factories were tasked with developing an all-terrain vehicle of its time. This is how the experienced ZIL 132 R appeared. Filipov was its leading designer. The car was equipped with an aluminum frame and a ZIL 130 V8 gasoline engine, boosted to 165 horsepower, and installed behind the new three-seater fiberglass cabin. The modernized onboard transmission included a dry double-disc clutch with a hydraulic drive, a synchronized 5-speed ZIL 137 gearbox with power takeoff, a transfer case with a locking differential and final drives in aluminum housings. For the first time for the ZIL series, a full-fledged independent link torsion bar suspension of all wheels appeared, and a dual-circuit pneumo-hydraulic system with ventilated disc brakes mounted on final drives was introduced. The front wheels were controlled by a power steering mechanism, the rear wheels were turned by means of a hydraulic tracking device. On the asphalt, the ZIL 132 R could increase the speed of 42 to 45 km/h, and on dirt roads it reached 20 to 24 km/h. The truck's cross-country ability was prohibitive, easily overcame half-meter fords, could move along a 25-degree slope and climb 30-degree inclines. Moreover, off-road exploits were ensured even with a full load. However, by 1980, all work on further refinement was curtailed.